£1 million in real banknotes to be won or lost. So sorry. But tonight, the drop is back with one big twist. A life-changing dilemma.
What would you put it on?
No!
Take on the final drop.
Let's play the final question
to double your money.
Come on.
There's a lot of money on there.
But risk losing the lot. Would you be tempted?
I'm not sure.
I don't know. Go.
This is the £1 million drop live.
Issue for me staying still. I'm very excited because it's Friday night and it is 9:03 and this is the £1 million drop live! Right, we are here every weekend for the next 6 weeks. Our security's back, our money's back, but you might just notice a couple of changes. And here's the first one. It's Sarah, Luke, Abby and Ruth! Sarah, Luke, Abby and Ruth are brother and sisters from Birmingham.
I love it. Ruth's literally like deep breathing while she comes up. She's
absolutely.
So, a bit different up here, isn't it?
Yes.
Just a little bit
different to earlier, definitely.
And which one out of you lot would you say is the boss?
That one.
I thought you were all pointing at someone different. You're the boss, Sarah.
I don't know what they're talking about.
Are you the oldest?
No.
So how did you get that?
I don't know. I've just always kind of been alpha in the family. It's just the way it's always been.
And tell me about your strategy.
Luke's our strategy. Yes,
Luke. Oh, you're it?
Luke is it. No pressure.
I'm the backbone.
And is it like that in the family as well? Do they sort of all look to you?
No.
Just on this show?
Just pressure's on you, just when there's money involved, that's it, really.
Right, so this series, you can take on the drop as a team as well as a pair, and you are our first, so welcome. Now, as always, you lot at home, you can play along with the Hartle family. You just need to go to channel4.com/drop or download the £1 million drop app. It's free. So there's 4 drops, 1 correct answer. You can spread your cash, but you must always leave 1 drop clear.
Okay?
Right, so we've dropped a question. So now just 7 stand between you and this £1 million. But make it to the end and you could have the chance to double your winnings by taking on the final drop. So if you play the perfect game, you could actually walk away with £2 million. Yeah. But get it wrong and you lose everything.
Yeah, there's a long way to go, yeah.
Yeah. So you're playing as a team. You don't get a choice of category. So this is it. Your first category is lyrics. So, only 2 of you can play at a time. You can switch players when you need to, but once you're out, you're out. So, who's going to be playing first?
I think me and Luke are going to do it.
The bossy one and the backbone.
Yes.
I like that. Okay, so Sarah and Luke, it's you. You've got £1 million. I've got 7 questions. Let's all play the £1 million drop live. You ready?
Yeah.
That's a lovely bit.
Here are the 4 possible answers for question 1. Okay. Because she's drunk.
Because she's young. Because she's on TV. Because it was Louis Walsh's fault. And the question is this. According to the lyrics of Talisa's first solo UK number one single, why should she be forgiven for what she's done? According to the lyrics of Talisa's first solo UK number one single, why should she be forgiven for what she's done?
Well, it's not going to be that.
It's not going to be Louis Walsh.
It's definitely because he's young. The song's called Young.
Young, are you sure?
Yeah,
not drunk.
The song's called Young, so.
Young, do you want to put any on drunk?
No. Hello.
50 seconds.
Are you sure?
Go, just go.
Are you sure?
Yes.
45 seconds.
Are you sure?
Yes.
According to the lyrics of Talisa's.
How do you know the lyrics to Talisa's music?
Solo number one single. Why should she be forgiven for what
because
she's done?
Because I work in a pub where students.
Is
so
that is that your excuse?
30
the
seconds.
The song is called Young.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Okay, should we stop? Do you want to stop it?
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. I think. Yeah, it makes sense. The song's called
20
Young.
20 seconds.
The song's called Young.
Yeah.
Okay.
Stop the clock.
Yeah.
Stop the clock. According to the lyrics of Talisa's first solo UK number one single, why should she be forgiven for what she's done? You've put your full million. Sarah, you weren't sure.
I don't really listen to modern pop music, I'm afraid.
But Luke, you put the full million on because she's young. So let's see what's going to drop. Says, forgive me for what I've done, because I'm young. So, you've got six questions to go, a cool million still in play. Congratulations, it's now time for question two of seven. The category is this. Politics. So, do you want to take it or switch players?
I'll switch the roof.
But then she's going to stay in.
We've got to decide.
What are you thinking?
She's being raising.
I think so.
She's
yeah.
going to be really angry, but I think we need to bring Ruth in.
Yeah.
So, who's she going to exchange with?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
100%.
Well, this is the game plan.
Yeah. Ruth is going to swap in, and she's going to swap with you, Sarah?
Yeah.
OK, Ruth, make your way to the drop, please.
Good luck. Thank you.
All right.
Okay, so the four possible answers in the politics category are... It is the most retweeted picture ever. It was taken to celebrate their 10th wedding anniversary. It was the poster for National Hug Day. That's not his wife he's hugging. The question is this. Take a look at this. So here it is. What is special about this picture taken in 2012?
That is, I think, definitely Michelle Obama.
Okay, so we can discount that one.
So it's definitely not that one.
That doesn't make any sense.
That one or that one?
Start splitting.
Yeah.
Clock started. What's special about that picture taken in 2012? Got 50 seconds on the clock.
Do you want to put anything else?
I think it's more likely to be this one.
45 seconds.
Okay.
Don't blame me if it's not.
No. So, that's definitely Michelle Obama.
I'm virtually certain that's Michelle Obama. Seconds. Unless it's his daughter. Is it one of his daughters?
Don't say that now.
Is it one of his daughters? Quick.
20 seconds.
Aren't the daughters younger than that, though?
I think so. I just put a bit on here just in case. Okay.
15 seconds.
That's still 200,000.
10, 9, 8, all right, 7, 6, oh, yeah. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's correct. 375150. Yeah. So, what's special about this picture taken in 2012? You got 150,000 on "That's not his wife he's hugging," 375,000 on "It's the most retweeted picture ever," and 475,000 on "It was taken to celebrate their 10th wedding anniversary." Let's see what's going to drop.
It's all right.
Okay, yeah. So, are you still in the game?
Oh God. We might not be.
You might not be. Let's see the final answer to drop.
I'm really sorry.
Not your fault.
Yes, you are. Move your money back. So it was tweeted after Barack Obama won the US presidential election last year. So, £375,000 still in play with 5 questions to go. We'll be back after this break. Are you playing along at home? Listen, it's so much fun. Just go to channel4.com/drop and you can download the mobile app if you want. There was a family that tweeted me earlier, said that they'd all downloaded the app and the one that lost buys the takeaway. Amazing. Anyway, you're doing great. Luke and Ruth, you've got 5 questions to go. £375,000 still in play. You can still switch in one player. Obviously, it's tougher this time round. There's only 7 questions to get through. It is a little bit tougher, so you are in a good position. Yep. All right? So, time now for question 3 of 7. The category is... language.
We're going to play?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to play.
We're going to play.
You're going to play?
Yeah.
Fantastic. So, the 4 possible answers in the language category are... Miliband. Cameron. Clegg. Farage. And the question is this. Which of these is a Malay word for vagina?
Oh, God.
Oh, I have no idea.
If it was my choice, it would be one of these two.
Okay, so that doesn't. How many.
Oh. We can have it on 3. What do you want to do?
The clock started.
So I think that these two sound more likely, but that doesn't mean they are.
What language is it?
Malay.
Which of these is a Malay word for vagina?
Any cities? Can you think of any cities in Kuala Lumpur?
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
45 seconds.
Do you want to put something on one of the others, just in case?
That's.
So it's equal on those two.
We've got 100 left.
Right, I'm going to put one there, put one on one of those. Put some on one of those.
30 seconds.
Yeah.
Which one are these two? Are we happy?
Yeah. Well, are you?
20 seconds.
I don't know, Luke. What do you think? I think that those two sound more likely.
Yeah.
But I don't know any Malay words, so no. I'm kind
10,
of in the dark.
Here. 9.
What do you reckon?
8.
Yeah,
7.
Leave it.
Yeah.
6.
Yeah, we'll leave it.
5. 4. 3. 2. Which of these is a Malay word for vagina? You put 50,000 on Cameron, 150,000 on Clegg, and 175,000 on Farage. Let's see what's going to drop. Miliband, is that a Malay word? Are you still in the game? Let's reveal the final answer to drop. Malay is the official language of Malaysia. You have four questions to go with 175,000 still in play.
Thank you.
So, we're going to drop one of the answers now, so you just face three possible answers. Time now for question 4 of 7. So, here's the category. Police. So, do you want to take it on, or are you going to switch players?
We'll take it on.
You're going to stay?
We'll try.
Okay, fantastic. You're staying on. So, the three possible answers are an out of control boomerang, a wallaby, Australian cricketer David Warner. And the question in the police category is this. Solihull Police tweeted this morning that what was on the loose?
It'll be this.
This morning.
It'll be this because
this morning.
Yeah, but
today.
Yeah, but Joe Root got punched in Birmingham by David Warner and Solihull. That police, I had that retweet.
But it was. You've had it retweeted on your feed.
I've seen tweets from them and they're always comedy tweets. And it was only yesterday it happened. It was in the papers yesterday.
Do you want to put any on Wallaby or any of these?
Do you?
Are you sure?
I'm fairly sure. Do you want to split it?
45 seconds.
Put 25 on something else then. But I think it's that.
40 seconds.
We'll go with that then.
And if we have lost all our money, I will apologise.
Out of control boomerang.
Swap it. If you want to put something on one of the others, then swap it. But I think that one is the best answer.
30 seconds.
In Birmingham. And Solihull, you know, is down the road.
Yes.
Do any of the others make sense? Would they be funny?
Suppose not, no.
There
20
you go.
Seconds.
That's funny. And that tweet, I get.
Solihull Police tweeted this
a
morning
lot,
that what was on the loose.
If I'm wrong, I'm wrong.
10, 9, 8, 7.
You're happy, I'm happy.
6.
I'm not happy.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Solihull Police tweeted this morning that what was on the loose, you put all of your money, after much humming and hawing, on Australian cricketer David Warner.
I really hope I didn't just do something.
Would they be doing comedy tweets, Solihull Police?
I'm pretty sure I've seen comedy from a Twitter name that on my Twitter feed. Pretty sure.
Let's see what's going to drop.
I might be wrong. All of those answers were silly.
Oh, darling! Oh, it was somebody's pet. Oh. And it was actually the police, Solihull Police.
Never mind.
But it was actually the serious police that tweeted. I'm so sorry.
It's fine.
Oh, it happened. We came with nothing.
You did, and you've had a nice time.
We've had a lovely day.
Okay, well, thank you so much to Abby and Sarah as well. We just want to say a big thank you to them as well. And thanks very much to the Hartle family. Oh, that was sad, wasn't it? Security are bringing up the £1 million. So, this series, as you can see, we're also looking for teams to take on the drop. So, do you fancy having a go? I mean, you could play with your workmates, you could play with your mates, you could play with your family. To apply, you just need to play our online game. So, go to channel4.com/drop, or you can download our mobile app, and your team could actually be here next weekend, that early. So, as security are putting the money out, let's welcome our next set of contestants. It's David and Christos!
David and Christos have been mates for 5 years. David is a 31-year-old teacher and Christos is a 35-year-old designer.
Hi, boys! You all right?
Yeah, I'm
doing. Yeah, good. You have to come forward. So, how are you feeling? How did you think they did? Would you have got that last one?
No,
they're hard questions.
They
really
are, they're a bit harder.
Yeah.
You've only got a 7 to get through, though.
Only 7.
To win
seven.
Money. It's that a shorter money. Journey, but a slightly tougher one.
Yeah, well, isn't
and there really? It is.
Wow.
£1 million. Yeah? David and Christos
beautiful.
Are going to be facing question one after the break. It's 9:30 and David and Christos, there it is, £1 million. But how much of that can you keep hold of over the next 7 questions? So, you happy with the rules?
Yes.
Yeah.
Fantastic. You've got £1 million. I've got 7 questions. Let's all play the £1 million drop. Okay, so here it is, question 1 of 8. Choose your category. Slang or partners?
Partners. Do you know much slang? You work in London. Come on, you must know some Cockney rhyming slang. Partners.
Go slang.
Should we go slang?
Go slang.
Slang. Let's go slang.
Slang it is. Slang. So the 4 possible answers in the slang category are... an ape. A bear. A lion. A whale. And the question is this. Which of these is defined in the Oxford English Dictionary as a term for a large, hirsute, homosexual or bisexual man?
Wow. OK.
Which of these is defined in the Oxford English Dictionary as a term for a large, hirsute, homosexual or bisexual man? Clock started.
It's still going to be whale, is it?
No, it's not going to be whale.
It can't be whale, so you can rule that out.
That's what it means, lion, lots of hair, right?
So, lion or a bear and ape? I'm thinking bear and ape myself, personally.
I think it's...
But should we start moving the money anyway?
Okay,
so, what?
45
ape,
seconds.
Do you think?
I think it's bear.
You think bear?
Or an ape. It's definitely not a whale. Lion doesn't
homosexual,
sound right.
Bisexual, a large suit homosexual, bisexual man. An ape. An ape, it's got to be an ape. Think about it. A bear, it's got no relation to humanity, has it? An ape has.
No, we don't know.
Yes, we do. You can put some money. Think about it.
No, trust me.
How can a bear. How can you say. A bear.
20 seconds.
A suit, homosexual, bisexual man. We're running out of time. Move the money. Move the money.
15 seconds.
Quick.
Put on each.
Quick.
10.
Quick.
9.
Don't put on.
8. 7.
Definitely.
6. 5. 4, 3, 2, 1. It's not worth falling out over.
That's normal for us.
Which of these is defined in the Oxford English Dictionary as a term for a large, hirsute, homosexual or bisexual man? So you've got 475,000 on a bear, 525,000 on an ape. Let's see what's going to drop.
No!
David, I heard you mutter under your breath, you saved me there.
I owe you big time.
He owes you, Christos. I'm sorry about that screen at the back, but you've got 6 questions to go and £475,000 still in play. 4% of the virtual money was placed on a whale? Yeah. So, David and Christos are going to be playing question 2 after the break.
It is 9:38. I'm going to be using this in future. Thank goodness I wore it tonight. You got through question one with a fabulous £475,000. So let's play question two of seven. The categories are bankers and celebrity.
Bankers, hasn't it?
So the big screen has gone down, but we've got the screens in front of us. So, okay, nice. What are you going to choose, bankers or celebrity?
There's been a lot of bankers in the press recently losing their knighthoods. We've got some bankers leaving their jobs.
I mean,
celebrity.
I don't want to go celebrity. Be,
you know, I think bankers. You all right with that?
Yeah, let's go bankers.
Bankers, because that's news, so, okay. Bankers,
okay, good
please.
News is the screen's back. Oh. So bankers it is. So the four possible answers in the bankers category are... sitting on his BlackBerry, headbutting his laptop, falling asleep on his keyboard, having sex on his desk. And the question is this. It was reported this week that a bank supervisor was in court for failing to notice a clerk had accidentally transferred millions of euros by doing what?
Having sex on his desk is an interesting way to transfer millions of euros. It's multitasking, if anything.
Might be sitting on his BlackBerry, right? So why is he? Because he's why
would he sit on his
BlackBerry and, you know,
back pocket?
Transfer money
could be
that.
The back pocket, couldn't it?
That's too
headbutting his laptop.
That seems a bit bizarre.
It was reported this week that a bank supervisor was in court for failing to notice that a clerk had accidentally transferred millions of euros by doing what?
Make it me.
I think he... yeah, because there's no way he's sitting on his bag. Definitely not that.
How do you know? I mean, if he was sitting there, he could sit down back pocket,
eating
his lunch.
30 seconds.
Hang on, who transfers money using his bag?
Headbutt on his lap.
Definitely not that one. Having sex on his desk is possible.
No, definitely.
20 seconds. It was reported this week that a bank supervisor was in court for failing to notice a clerk had accidentally transferred millions of euros by doing what? 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It was reported this week that a bank supervisor was in court for failing to notice that a clerk had accidentally transferred millions of euros by doing what? You put all of your money, not that sure, all of your money on £475,000.
Yeah.
Was that the right thing to do?
I definitely
was. Falling asleep on his keyboard. Yeah. Let's see what's going to drop.
Yes!
So brave, and it really paid off. Move your money back. He accidentally changed what was a minor transfer into a €222,222,222.22 transfer.
Whoa. Wow, that's a lot of twos.
In his sleep! That's so bad! Well done, guys. Five questions to go and a very healthy £475,000 still in play. Stand now for question three of seven. Choose your category. Names or squares?
Squares? I mean, it's like squares in cities, like...
yeah, tons of squares in
lots
London.
Lots of different squares. I don't know the names of lots of squares. Names...
could be names of squares.
Could be names of squares, so... I mean, what would you like to go for? I'm thinking names, personally. Because if it's squares in cities, I
squares.
Wouldn't know. Yeah?
I'm going to have to ask you for a decision, I'm afraid.
Not names?
I'm easy.
Let's go names, then.
Names?
Okay. Names it is. The four possible answers in the names category are... USA. Republic of Ireland. Australia. UK. And the question is this. According to the website publicprofiler.org, in which of these countries is Smith not the most common surname?
Right, well, Smith's very common in the UK, isn't it? OK, and we're looking for a country that's not the most common surname. It's common in the UK. Australia, you get a lot of emigration across from the UK and so on.
According to the website, publicprofiler.org, in which of these countries is Smith?
I think Ireland, because Ireland's
the most common surname.
I haven't heard of many Smiths in Ireland. Australia, you get a lot of emigration over from the UK. USA, a lot of emigration over as well. Do you want to split some money? Or do you want to risk it and put it all on Ireland?
Think?
I don't. UK is very common, but maybe
30
you know,
seconds.
I think I don't want to put it all in one. Let's not put it. Should we try the UK because you know names have changed a lot over the years and maybe
20 seconds.
Let's put some on the UK. Just put I think so. Just
15
because we need to get
seconds.
Through, don't we? And what about these two?
10.
Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
You're making me nervous just watching you guys. According to the website publicprofiler.org, in which of these countries is Smith not the most common surname? You left USA, Australia clear and put 100,000 on the UK and 375,000 on the Republic of Ireland. So let's see what's going to drop. Smith's the most popular in the UK, followed by Jones, and exactly the same in Australia. So, are you going through to the next question? Let's reveal the final answer to drop. Followed by Kelly. Move your money back. Everyone at home, are you cheating? Are you? Because we've actually crashed the publicprofiler.org website. Congratulations, guys. Four questions to go and a very healthy £375,000 still in play. So we're going to drop one of the answers now. You're going to face just three possible answers. All the same rules apply. You've got to leave one drop clear. All right? Time for question 4 of 7. Choose your category. Campaigns or controversy?
Well, you know a lot of controversy because it follows you around, but campaigns.
Don't know, campaigns.
Should we go with controversy? I think it's more likely to be in the news, I don't know.
Okay, let's go there. I'm happy to go there.
Okay, controversy. Please.
Controversy it is. The three possible answers in the controversy category are Robin Thicke has a big dick. Robin Thicke is really a chick. Robin Thicke is a massive prick. Take a look at this. Here's the question. That's the explicit video of the current UK number one by Robin Thicke. What phrase spelled out in balloons in this video is censored in the clean version? That's the explicit video of the current UK number one by Robin Thicke. What phrase spelled out in balloons in this video is censored in the clean version?
If that's his video, it's definitely not going to be...
Well, if it's explicit, Why would they censor chick for an explicit video?
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
So I would rule that out because
it's not going to be. So you call yourself a massive
think
prick,
prick
is it?
Or dick? Well, it's not him. Is that? Is it his single?
I don't know. Okay. Hang on. That's his single.
It's his single. So he's. You think it's this one? I don't think it's going to be this.
And why would the censor really change?
40 seconds on the clock.
Should start moving.
I'm sure
in
the paper today. You know, talking about, it was an interview with him, they were talking about he had a special
Is that what,
thing. Right.
So you think we should put our money on the
I think we go all in.
All in? All in?
That's
sure,
the explicit
about
video
it.
Of
Do you
the
want to save at least a couple?
No,
what phrase spelled out balloons in this video is censored in the clean version.
All in.
Are you sure about this? I think we should split our money.
It's risky. It's risky.
Chris, I think we should split our money. I think we should put some over here.
10, 9, 8, 7. 6,
that's a bit of a long
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So we saw the explicit video of the current UK number one by Robin Thicke. What phrase spelled out in balloons in this video is censored in the clean version? So you put all of your money. David did want to spread a little bit, but Christos, you took a risk, persuaded him to put it all on. Robin Thicke has a big dick.
Yep.
Let's see what's going to drop.
That's right.
So are you going through to the next question, or is this where we say goodbye? Was David right? We'll find out after the break.
No!
Is a 9:54, having a bit of a problem with the screen again, but before the break, we saw a video. It was an extremely explicit video for the current UK number one by Robin Thicke, and I asked you what phrase spelled out in balloons in this video is censored in the clean version. We're left with two options. David, I know that you wanted to spread between these two, and Christos, you persuaded him to put all of your money, £375,000, on Robin Thicke has a big dick.
Yeah.
Are you going through to the next question? Let's see the final answer to drop. Yes, you are! Video makes me feel sick to the stomach, that does. Guys, what a great position. Three questions to go, £375,000 still in play. Time now for question 5 of 7. You're so nearly there, so choose your category. We've got sports or classic TV.
Classic TV.
Like a bit of classic TV.
40 Towers, Only Fools and Horses. Sports.
Sports is too. That's too ambiguous. Let's just go TV.
Yeah.
Classic.
TV.
Classic TV.
Classic TV. Okay.
Classic TV. It is. So the three possible answers in the classic TV category are the A-Team van, the mystery machine in Scooby-Doo, Where Are You, Postman Pat's van. And the question is this. Which was the first of these vans to appear on TV?
Wow.
Okay, well.
How old are. Postman Pat is seriously old, isn't it?
I think it's the oldest.
I mean.
18 van, I mean, I watched that. What, 80s?
Clock started.
18
watched
vans.
Watched that in the 80s.
Late 70s, was it?
I don't know what I think this is. I think it's the 70s, because it'll get up in there, 70s.
Well, which one? I think Postman Pat might be the oldest, because it's a cartoon.
So which one is it?
It's a very old animation.
I don't think it's the 18th, I think that's...
Do you think the animation's here? So do you think it's one of these two?
I think it's one of these two, because I think that's more 70s, that was
80s. 40 seconds on the clock.
I haven't got a clue about Postman Pat, but...
That was animation, wasn't it? Whereas these were TV, so would this come later because it's animation?
I think it might be this, but I think...
30 seconds.
Definitely put money on it.
Yeah, OK.
I think we split between these two.
Yeah?
These two.
How much? Just two? Just split it?
Split it.
How much you got there?
20 seconds.
What, half and half? Got 100. Should I put some over?
Yeah, just split it.
15
equal.
Seconds.
Split equals. I think it might be that. Maybe one more on that.
10 seconds. 9.
No, the other
eight,
way, not that.
Okay. 7.
So 200, 175, you think?
5.
Is that right?
4.
Yeah, it's just 3.
3.
Oh.
2.
Okay.
Yeah, let's just do
one.
That.
No, it's definitely that one.
Which was the first of these vans to appear on TV. £175,000 on Postman Pat's van, £200,000 on The Mystery Machine in Scooby-Doo, Where Are You? Let's see what's going to drop. So Postman Pat's from 1981, you were right, Christos, it's much later. And the 18 from 1983, but Scooby-Doo was from 1969 in the US and 1970 in the UK. You were right, the clothes said it all. Move your money back. Do you know, even though I was a little bit worried about you guys at the beginning, that you weren't going to get on or that you were going to have sort of big rows, but actually you've played a bit of a blinder. You've got two questions to go. And £200,000 still in play. That's amazing. Wow. The over 30s, well done to all of you playing at home. You did much better than the under 30s on that question. So, you ready for question 6 of 7?
Yep.
Fantastic. Choose your category. So, we've got pageants or Quentin Tarantino?
Well, if it's Tarantino's films, you know much about his films.
Well, everyone knows.
Because I know nothing about pageants, beauty pageants. I mean, I have no idea. Should we go with Tarantino? We might have a bit more shared knowledge
then,
on that.
I think that's going to be the easier one, but it might just be some ridiculous...
I think Tarantino. We've got more shared knowledge on Tarantino than we do pageants.
OK, yeah, true.
Yeah.
All right, yeah.
Tarantino. Quentin Tarantino. So the three possible answers in the Quentin Tarantino category are... Death Proof. Kill Bill, Volume 1, Pulp Fiction. And the question is this. For which of these films does Quentin Tarantino not have a credit as an actor?
I'm pretty sure he's in Pulp Fiction.
Who is he in Pulp Fiction?
He only has a... He just has bit parts.
But who is he in that?
I don't know. I'm sure he's in that. I don't know.
Stop starting.
Kill Bill, he's... one of them is like, he's got... comes around with his coffee. Oh, what was that scene?
Is it Kill Bill, in the caravan? Does he come around in the caravan when she's in the caravan? Do you want to go Pulp Fiction Death Proof? Because I haven't seen Death Proof.
45 seconds. For which of these films does Quentin Tarantino not have a credit as an actor?
And...
I think he's in Pulp Fiction. Kill Bill, is it more of a recent thing he does, or...?
30 seconds.
I don't know, so you want to split between these two? I don't know, just don't know.
25 seconds.
I really don't know. I've never seen Death Proof, so I've no idea. Obviously, in old films. Did he used to put himself in his old films?
Yeah,
famous, he put himself in newer films.
To be honest, I think we've done all right.
Just 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We asked you for which of these films does Quentin Tarantino not have a credit as an actor? Was he in Pulp Fiction? Was he? You didn't put any money on it. Kill Bill Volume 1, Death Proof. You split your money between the two, £100,000 on each. Let's see what's going to drop. Plays a barman called Warren in Death Proof. Was he in Pulp Fiction? Are you going through to question seven? Let's reveal the final answer to drop. £100,000. So, I just wanted to say very quickly that was very well played because nearly half the people playing along at home didn't survive that question. So well done. So we're here. We've got £100,000 in play. So you possibly could win that in this next question. So just tell me, what would that sort of money mean to you guys?
Means an awful lot. Been my girlfriend quite a long time, and she's starting to ask pestering questions, so that might pay the way for a few things.
Say no more. Christos?
Yeah, definitely money for a house, go travelling a little bit, stop working for a little time.
Yeah, just take a little sabbatical, yeah, exactly. A few months, go see the world.
Yeah. That'd be lovely.
It'd be amazing.
Well, let's crack on. We're dropping out another answer. So you face just two, and as always, you've got to leave one drop clear. So you are either leaving here with £100,000 or nothing. Let's play question seven. So for £100,000, choose your category. Inventions or world records?
Inventions, wow. World records. Had a few broken at the Olympics last year in swimming. I can't remember the names of the characters.
There are hundreds. You mean it's going to be invention? I'd go inventions.
Yeah, okay. I'm all right, because, yeah, inventions, it's a bit random. So we might.
Yeah, random's good.
Random's good.
Inventions.
Inventions.
Inventions it is. So the two possible answers in the inventions category are electricity meter, parking meter. And the question is this. Which of these was invented first?
Invented first. Parking meter. Cars have been around for, what, 120 odd years now?
Yeah.
In America.
Which seems a bit strange. Parking meter, though.
Think about America, where.
Look, started.
You know, parking meters aren't as big a deal here as, you know, they are more so now, but in America.
Electricity. What does that. What exactly is that?
Electricity meter. Well, yeah. Hang on, maybe the electricity meter, because how would they have been able to calculate how much electricity people are using when they first started introducing it into houses?
Yeah.
Because at the moment, you know, they calculate when
they its own parking meter.
I don't know. Electricity meter, I think.
Where are you going? What do you think? I'm edging towards electricity meter.
I think electricity meter because.
30 seconds. Which of these was invented first?
How much people use them?
Yeah. Parking meter. I don't think parking was an issue, mate.
Electricity meter. Cars on the road weren't many. Parking as well, isn't it?
Weren't many cars until
rolled out more.
Even forecast in 50s or 60s.
Sure. 15 seconds on the clock.
Yeah. Just go electricity.
Electricity meter.
10. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3, 2, 1. Which of these was invented first? Parking meter, you left clear. £100,000 riding on electricity meter. For £100,000, have you beaten the £1 million drop? Let's find out. After the break. No! Welcome back to the final part of of the £1 million drop live. It is 11 minutes past 10, and before the break, we got to question 7 with a massive £100,000. And I asked you boys which of these was invented first, and you deliberated and deliberated. Mm. You left parking meter clear and put your £100,000 on electricity meter. So, for £100,000, have you beaten the £1 million drop? Let's find out. But the electricity meter in the later 1800s. So you take your money.
Wow.
Take your money. Hold it. Hold it. You can hold it for a minute. Enjoy it. Look at it. Sniff it.
This is my bit.
It is your money. But it doesn't necessarily end here. Guys, you've got a little bit of a decision to make now. OK? So, £100,000. That would be really amazing. But you know what would be even better than £100,000? £200,000. Yeah. So you can take that right now, or you can choose to play the final drop. That would mean doubling your money to £200,000. All you have to do is correctly answer one more question. OK? But if you get it wrong, you lose everything. So, to help you, we are going to show you the two possible answers to the question in the final drop. So, they are Stevie Wonder, David Bowie. So, what do you think?
Could be a DNA exhibition, couldn't it?
I don't know much about Stevie Wonder. I know a few of his songs.
Hits,
I know more Bowie songs.
My suitcase
here, who had this, who had that. I mean, I'm quite happy, to be honest.
But you could have this.
What are you thinking? David, you're tempted, aren't you?
I am tempted, but this money means so much to me. And I don't know how live with losing it, but then doubling it.
I mean, yeah, exactly. I would love to go for have a risk on one of these, but if I lose this,
that's it, game over.
So, are you going to take on the final drop? I'm going to have to push you for a decision,
guys.
You're going to take the money.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Well done, guys. So, guys, just for fun, let's have a look and see what the question was, shall we?
Okay.
Yeah, just for fun. Okay, the question was, according to the official charts company, which of these had a UK top 40 single first? So what would you have said?
Initially, Stevie Wonder, David Bowie's 70s, Stevie Wonder, but number one.
Yeah, but number first, UK.
UK.
Initially, Stevie Wonder, but
David Bowie said.
So would you have said Stevie Wonder?
Probably would have gone with that.
Yeah.
You would have won £200,000.
Oh, that's all right.
That's all right.
But you got £100,000, and your girlfriend's going to be one happy girl. Amazing that they won £100,000. Quite frustrating that they didn't play, but I think I'm quite happy. I'm happy.
They went away very happy. And I bet David's girlfriend's going to be just rapping up and down. I'm going to get a ring. I'm getting a ring. OK, so 27 people playing along still have their starting million. I know, right? It's tougher, isn't it? Under 30s are doing the best so far, so well done. And Team Omega, I'm never quite sure how to say it. Omega's really American. Team Omega in the Northeast still have their starting million, so well done, you guys. So, security are bringing up the £1 million. Listen, are you a group of mates? Or maybe you're a family watching at home or playing along together and reckon you could beat the drop? Well, this series, you have got the chance. Now, to apply, you've got to get online, channel4.com/drop, or you could download the mobile app, and your team could actually be right here, standing on this stage next weekend. Right, let's welcome our next set of contestants. It's Lizzie, Jonathan, Will, and Amy! Jonathan is a retired project manager from Lincolnshire, and tonight he's playing with his three kids, Lizzie, Will, and Amy.
Hi, Jonathan, all right? Nice to see you. Hi, guys! Hiya.
Wasn't that exciting? All right, dude.
I don't know how you feel.
The best surname ever. the Dukes.
It.
It's like you should have a TV programme about yourself. Did you hear about a film recently called The Croods?
Yeah.
You could be the Dukes.
Maybe after tonight Love it. We will, yeah.
Yeah? Maybe you will. Maybe. So, Dream Team, how's it going to pan out? Have you thought about a strategy?
Yes, yeah. But I don't know whether it's...
What is it? Tell
See
me what
it
is.
Goes.
No recriminations. I reckon I've got the Dream Team around me. Whatever happens,
I think
will
all
happen.
Ages are our strengths.
Yeah.
You've
yeah.
got
yeah.
all bases covered, haven't you, yeah. with the yeah. with the age difference? And I think that is helpful, yeah. actually.
That's the
so,
idea.
There it is. £1 million in cash. But how much of that can you keep over the next 7 questions? So, you understand the rules?
Yep.
Fantastic. You, now only 2 of you can play at a time. You can switch players when you need to, but once you're out, you're out. All right? So, let's have a look at your first category. Your first category is... the FBI. So, who do you think is going to play this first question?
Do you two want it?
Me and Lizzie.
Yeah. Yeah. You two have it.
Yeah.
You want it?
Yeah.
Me and Amy will go.
Okay, Lizzie and Amy, yeah. you're going to play the first question. You've got £1 million. Yeah. I've got 7 questions. Mm-hmm. Let's all play the £1 million drop live. Yeah. 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 Right, listen, here are the 4 possible answers for question number 1. Identity theft. Money laundering. Economic espionage. Paranormal activity. So the question for the FBI category is, according to the FBI's What We Investigate page on their official website, which of these is not listed as something they would investigate?
Yes. Okay. Yes. No. Paranormal activity. The FBI are not going to get involved in ghosts.
No, it's not UFOs, is it? Paranormal.
No, paranormal.
Is ghosts.
Or is it
the
aliens?
Clock started.
Is it aliens?
That's extra.
According to the FBI, it's not the investigate page on their official website.
It's not
these
something.
Is not
sorry, sorry.
Listed as something that they would real. Investigate.
Come on, quicker.
Are you sure?
Well, what do? What is
keep
that?
Going, okay, keep going.
What is
okay.
that? Gonna, what is that?
Economic, like spying, money spying.
So yes, then.
So that's like money laundering. All connected. Identity
theft. Yeah, because if I was trying to be you, then someone would stop me.
30 seconds on the clock.
It's all right, we're all right, Amy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
We don't want to split?
No. Money laundering is massively illegal. That is massively illegal. And I only just learnt what that is.
20 seconds.
Sure? You promise you know what
15
that is?
15 seconds.
Yeah, economic espionage is spying. Spying on economics.
So FBI would do
10,
that.
10, money laundering.
9. FBI would do that.
8.
They're not going to look at ghosts.
7. 6.
If that's ghosts,
5,
not UFOs.
4,
my toilet flushed on its
3,
own. Is the FBI
2,
going to look?
1.
No.
Oh, no.
According to the FBI's What We Investigate page on their official website, which of these is not listed as something they would investigate?
Not listed as something.
You've put your full million, everything, on paranormal activity.
Not listed, yeah.
Yeah. Let's see what's going to drop. Need to call Ghostbusters for that. You got six questions to go and a cool £1 million still in play. Very nice. Very bold play. You've learned something new.
Yes.
Today is very good.
Every day learning.
Right, time now for question 2 of 7. So, the category is this.
Oh, yeah.
Marriage.
Stay in.
So what are you going to do? You're going to stay in or swap out?
Wedding stuff. You're getting married, so you're probably going to read up on everything.
Are you?
Yeah.
Read a lot of brides' magazines.
When's that?
May next year.
Yay!
Yeah. Okay, we're going to play.
You're going to play? Fantastic. So let's see. The four possible answers in the marriage category are... Japan. Oh. Spain. Netherlands, Brazil, and the question is this. In 2001, what became the first country in the world to legalise same-sex marriage?
I want to lead towards Netherlands, but that's just a guess.
They're quite liberal.
This is a really hard one.
Spain, it's really Catholic.
Stop moving a bit. So they're not going to do Spain, is it? Catholics won't let...
Clock started.
It was the first country to legalise same-sex marriage, so it won't be Spain.
I don't think Japan.
Quick, we're going to stop moving. What, Netherlands and Brazil?
Yeah.
You never really see any same-sex Japanese people. What do you think?
How sure are you?
I'm just leaning towards it because it was an instinct and I don't know.
You've got 30 seconds on the clock, girls.
What do you want? More towards another one? What do you think? Think about it. Spain, Catholic...
Spain immediately was my first one I thought.
No. First country, so not
20
Spain.
20 seconds.
And I've never heard of it being in Japan.
Do you want to put one in Japan?
No, it's 25 grand.
15 seconds.
Okay, second question.
It's only 10. Question.
Quick.
9. Right,
well, you go then.
8.
No,
go quick. 7.
Amy, do you want one on
6,
there or not?
5.
Go on.
4. 3. Just 2. One. In 2001, what became the first country in the world to legalise same-sex marriage? £25,000 on Japan?
If it is
Japan, £25,000 isn't going to get you very far.
But we'll know all the other answers. So
£425,000 on Brazil, £550,000 on the Netherlands. Let's see what's going to drop.
Oh, gosh, this is real life. Oh, my God, it got scary when it drops down.
Legalised in 2005 in Spain and 2013 in Brazil. Another very Catholic country.
Oh, yeah.
Japan.
Oh, yeah.
Or the Netherlands. You are going through, but if you have £25,000, how far are you going to get? Let's reveal the final answer to drop.
I don't know. I think it's going to go, Amy.
I just don't know.
I think it's going to go.
Japan have yet to legalise same-sex marriage, but the Netherlands legalised in 2001. Move your money back. Congratulations. Just want to say a quick hello to everybody playing at home right now, and those of you in a relationship, you all did best on that question, so well done. So, a lovely 5 questions to go, £550,000 still in play. Well done. Right, so time for question 3 of 7. Here's your category.
It's sport. So, are you going to stay or switch?
William.
Swap one in.
Yeah, William.
William.
Swap
me. So,
William.
For who?
Me.
William. Amy for William.
So, Amy's going to go and William's going to come. William, if you want to come to the drop, please.
Well done.
You are just too cute
and for single.
Gorgeous. You look lovely. Okay, so welcome to the game, Will. Haven't they done well?
They've done so well.
Let's have a look at the four possible answers for the sport category. They are Roger Federer's Wimbledon men's single final wins. Michael Phelps' total Olympic gold medal wins. Phil Taylor's PDC World Championship wins. Manchester United's FA Cup final wins.
Right.
And the question is this. Which of these is the highest number?
Right, William.
OK, Michael Phelps has won...
He's got like 30.
I don't know.
No, he hasn't, William. Think about it, please.
He's got like 20.
He got 10 last 4 years ago, didn't he? Did he get one more this time?
I don't know.
Clock started.
Roger Federer has won, I don't know, five times, six times. Manu
has
won 20 FA Cups.
What's
and
this?
And I don't watch darts, but he's...
Oh, that's darts.
I think Phil Taylor's quite good.
So how many would he have won?
I don't know. I'd say Michael Phelps.
No. What about that?
No, not, it's not Roger Federer.
How many FA Cups have they won? Quick, stop moving.
Several.
How many? William, have a think, please.
I am thinking.
30 seconds.
Please think something.
Okay, it's not Roger Federer.
What has he won? He's won it like ten times.
No, he's won it like five
Which
or six.
Which of these is the highest number?
Darts, not FA.
He's won like 15 or so.
What about Man United?
It's not Man United.
How many have they won, do you think?
Not that many.
Do you think?
Not
give
as
me a
many
number.
As that. 10? 7 or 8?
10, 9,
what's that?
8,
who's still
7,
darts,
6,
like most famous darts.
5,
but
4,
10
3,
not as many
2,
as Michael Phelps
1. Which of these is the highest number? Will, you were pretty certain that it was Michael Phelps. I know, Lizzie, you were very nervous about that. I mean, it's very difficult when you're just literally going on someone else's knowledge.
You get an idea for things, but I want to hear numbers from you.
He gave you the best he could, Lizzie. He put 150,000 on Phil Taylor's PDC World Championship wins and 400,000 on Michael Phelps' total Olympic gold medal wins.
And then we got 10. We've got
Let's see what's going to drop.
We've got...
OK, Manchester United's FA Cup final wins.
Well done, William.
11. You were... I think you were right, actually. I think
Would
you said
say
that. Roger Federer, you were almost right there as well. 7 singles titles, you said 5, so well done. You're going through to the next question, which is great, but the best thing that could happen to you right now is that you lose £150,000. Let's see the final answer to drop.
I just don't know darts.
Will, you played a blinder. Well done. Move your money back. Well, Lizzie, 4 questions to go. £400,000 still in play. And what a great piece of gameplay bringing Will in at that time.
Yeah, me and Amy would have sunk on that one. I don't think we'd have done well.
I don't get the credit I deserve in this family.
Oh, honestly, you deserve a lot of credit. That was fantastic. And you've still got one more person that you can swap in.
Yeah.
So that's great. Sadly, that's it from us for tonight. But if you're playing along at home, don't go anywhere because your very own final drop question is coming up now. We'll be back tomorrow at 8 o'clock to see if the Dougs family can keep hold of this £400,000 and Made in Chelsea's Ollie Locke and Mark Francis Vandelli take on the drop for charity. See you then. Night-night.